everyone, it's Becky here. How are you all doing? So welcome to another video. Today I'm doing yet another tag video, which is very strange because it's third tag video in a row, but don't you worry, I'm not turning into a tag lady. It just happened that I was tagged by a lovely another booktuber, and that's what I'm gonna do today. And the tag I'm going to do is called Your Answer Can't Be Books tag, which was originally created by BookBuds, and I was kindly tagged by Shelly from Shelly Sveringen. And without the further ado, let's just go to the prompts because they are really, really great. I was really enjoying watching other people doing this tag, so let's just tackle those. Okay, so the first tag says, what is something that you own way too many of other than books? Well, this is going to be a little bit weird, but since I was young, I always like to call it sort of like paper bags or paper pockets. I don't even know how to call it, so I just have something to show you here. And you know, these sort of things, like when you go to gift shops or some sort of, I don't know, jewelry shop or wherever you go, you usually can receive your small presents or things you buy in these sort of like paper pockets. And it didn't took me a while to realize that every shop has its own, you know, like patterns or design, and I just really like them, and I ended up buying, well, not buying, but just collecting them. And wherever I would go with my family for holiday or just somewhere else, I would always bring this as a souvenir. And I literally have the full the full box of these sort of paper pockets or paper bags, and I just really love them and I cherish them, because even when I was, for example, on high school and my classmates would go to holiday somewhere, they would always bring me these sort of paper bags. And I don't know what I'm gonna do with these, because it starts to be a really big pile of them, but yeah, I just have them and I collect them. And yeah, so this is something I own way too much, and I have really no clue what is the purpose of these and what I'm gonna do with them one day, but they are here and I like them very much. And then maybe the second thing I would say, because since I mentioned already that I'm quite sensitive but also sentimental person, I really do like to collect memorabilia, you could say. And in my room I have this thing which I called a memory box, and I always collect them, some sort of items which are very important to me and that brings me some sort of physical memories. And those can be old sort of things, you know, from, for example, cards which I receive for my birthday or name days, because in Slovakia we also celebrate name days other than birthdays. And well, we do celebrate birthdays as well, but also name days. And in that memory box I have all these sorts of like cards and photographs, or even some sort of like maybe little stones which I brought from somewhere when I went to travel, or when I was doing, for example, summer camps for children when I was younger. Well, I was doing it for like 7 years, and we would have this camp post, so you and children are writing little notes to each other. So I, for example, have there all the notes or a little post which children ever gave to me. So yeah, this sort of things. I wouldn't say I'm like a materialist person, because I don't need to, you know, like buy many things, but whenever it comes to having some sort of things that brings you like a physical memory, that's something I have way too many of. So that would be the first tag. What is something that you do for fun that's not reading a book? Okay, so answer for this came as an inspiration from Shelly herself, because she mentioned that she really likes visiting people, and that's something I really do like as well, because I am very a social person and I like to be with people. So I would definitely say that spending time with my friends or family or just going places with someone, that's something I really like to do. But also I am very versatile person, so I always find something to do, whether it's like painting or photography or sometimes knitting during the winter. And I do love doing sports. I do love Zumba, and sometimes I remember, was it like 2 years ago, I even tried the course of swing dance and Charleston, and I really, really love it, and I would love to do it more, but now, you know, lockdown and COVID and everything is not possible, but I always find something to do. Question number 3. What is something special or important on your nightstand that it's not a book? Well, this is quite funny, because I actually do not place anything else on my nightstand other than book, because the way my bed and my nightstand is positioned, I basically have my head on the other side than my nightstand. So usually everything I need to have near me I have on the floor, which is weird, but it's just the way how I have the furniture in my room. I cannot have the nightstand next to my head. So I usually always put my book on the nightstand, but then the little lamp, I had it on the floor. And same when I have, for example, my phone sometimes, which is horrible, but yes, shamefully, I'm one of those people who has the phone right next to them, and the first thing I check in the morning is my phone, which is horrible. But yeah, so other than book, that would be lamp and the phone and headphones, but currently it's on the floor and not the nightstand. Right, number four. What's something did you buy at bookstore other than books? I must confess that I don't actually buy many things in bookstores other than books, because I'm not the type of person who would buy, you know, like bookmarks or these sort of things they sell there. But one thing, for example, when I used to be in Scotland and I would go to Waterstones, I would always get tea. That's something that's probably one thing I always buy, because I like to go there, sit there and work from there, from the coffee shop which is in the bookstore, and just work there with my laptop or even read the book which I either buy already or just bring with me. And so yeah, definitely tea. And then when I'm in Slovakia, for example, I usually don't go to this sort of like coffee shop parts, but I do like to buy notebooks, because that's maybe one thing I actually have way too many of. That's true, because I do love to write everything by hand. I'm not the type of person who would write stuff in the phone or in the laptop. I prefer to write everything in hand, and I really do have a thing for lovely notebooks, and I might have way too many of them, but I always use them as well. So notebooks would be another thing I have way too many of, and that's something which I buy in bookstores other than books. Right, what's a fun gift that you received that wasn't a book or gift card for books? Well, usually I would say that if I receive some gift, it's usually bookish related, but when it comes to other gifts, I wouldn't say they are really funny, because usually they are quite a personal stuff which I receive for a person. Or then, oh actually yeah, I have this one mug, because I really do like sloths, like the animals. I really find them cute and adorable and very calming, because they're just, you know, always calm. And I have this one mug which you actually seen in one of my previous videos, and it's a mug which has little sloth hanging on the tea branch, and the background is all black, but once you put the hot water or coffee or something into it, the black background will turn into lovely baby blue with pinkish flowers. And I just love that mug so much. See, because although I'm 24, I'm very childish like when it comes to this sort of you know, mug that is turning a color or something like this. This just makes me extremely happy, even though it's really something you don't necessarily need. But I mean, I would not buy it myself probably, but if someone give something like this to me, I'm just all child again, and I just love this stuff. So that would be maybe one funny thing I have. What's a YouTube channel that you watch that's not related to books? I really do watch quite a lot of channels when it comes to photography. I really do love, oh my gosh, I completely forgot his name, Sean. Okay, I put the name here, but he is amazing guy who is doing absolutely lovely photographs, and mostly black and white, and he also published his first book right now. I don't know if it's first, I think it's first, but I really want to get that book as well, so definitely check him out. But also, I do love Katie Jobling, because she is doing a lot of tutorials when it comes to painting with oil paints and especially acrylics, and it's something I really love to follow because I like to paint. And then one more I will mention, because if you want some sort of like peacefulness and joy, definitely check out Jona Jinten, if you don't know about her yet, because she is this Swedish artist who is doing a lot of filmmaking and photography, and she also started to do her own jewelry with her husband, and her videos are just, they make me cry literally, like the nature and oh my, yeah, just check her out, it's amazing. And then other than that, I'm watching I always have some sort of workout videos, because that's how I like to do some exercise. Like usually it's either going for a run, not in these heat waves, but then I'm inside and I just do some workouts from YouTube. Right, and the last one is... I cannot speak. Last one is tag 5 booktubers that you want to learn more about. So I have the whole list here, and I would really like to tag Stephanie from For Love and Novels, Ellie from BBD Babidi Books, Margaret from Margaret Pinyard channel, and then two more channels, the Danish Readaholic and also the Personal Cozy Project. So ladies, if you haven't done this tag and you're watching this video and you're interested to do this, please do so, because I would love to know more stuff about you. And yeah, that's me done. I hope you enjoyed this tag, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you with another video very soon. Also, I'm very excited for my next upcoming video, because I'm going to do my first ever comparison video, book and film, and I'm a little bit nervous because I never done anything like this before, but I'm just, I don't know, I hope you will like it. So yes, this was another tag video, but the next video, I promise, will be something different. So hopefully you will enjoy it as well. So take care until now, and I will see you very soon again. Bye bye!